Hallo, my name is Lore, engineer of the Daikin Europe Technical Service and Control Division. With this video, I would like to introduce Daikin eDoctor, part of eCare, an application to guide our Daikin colleagues and installer in troubleshooting a unit. Let's get started. Here you see the home screen of the eCare application, where we can open eDoctor. You start a new session, or you can also continue a previous session. We'll come back to that later. Now we will start a new session. Selection of the unit can be done via QR code scanning. If you want all available information to be visible, please make sure you scan the inner unit, outer unit and other applicable components. If you are not in front of a unit, or the unit does not have a QR code, you can also enter the model name and serial number manually. We have an autocomplete function for the model name, so this will make finding a model easier. This is the home screen of eDoctor. On top you can see the details of the service manual where eDoctor finds his information. A service manual is available on the business portal if you prefer to work on paper or on a personal computer. We provide three starting points for our troubleshooting: error and symptom-based troubleshooting, in case you have an error, or if the unit is acting strange. In case you already know which component you want to check, you can go to the component check. If you need help in the removal or the installation of a component, you can use the component repair. First, we will go into detail of the error and symptom-based troubleshooting. A full list of all error codes is provided. You can find your applicable error code by scrolling or by entering it into the search bar. We give you the trigger for each error code, the effect this will have on the unit, and how to reset the error code after you found the root cause. eDoctor guides you in how to solve the error code by giving you a list of components to check in a recommended order. Let's check, for example, the water flow sensor. By pushing on this tab, eDoctor continues the component check of the water flow sensor. We want to check the component. For this part, only an electrical check is available. Step by step, we show you how to make sure the component is functioning as expected, or if it's broken. At the end of each component check, you get a question. Depending on your answer, eDoctor knows what the next step is. Let's say the result is that the flow sensor needs to be replaced. eDoctor will now continue with the repair procedure of the flow sensor. You decide you need help to remove or install the flow sensor. eDoctor gives you all removal and installation procedures using clear instructions and pictures. We now finish an example of how the eDoctor guides you from error code to parts replacement. Let's go back to our troubleshooting and focus on symptoms now. In the symptom-based troubleshooting, we'll find a list of all known symptoms. Each symptom can have more than one possible failure. A root cause, check, and repair instruction is given for each failure. When we go back to the home screen of eDoctor, the second possibility is to start your troubleshooting with a component check. A list of all components is given. You can either scroll to the required component or you can use the search function. Depending on the component, you can have different types of checks: electrical, mechanical, position check, or others. By selecting your check procedure, eDoctor will give you clear, step-by-step instructions and pictures to help you. The last of the three start points of troubleshooting is the component repair, in case you already know which part needs replacement. Select the component. Select if you need help in the installation or removal of the part, and find the required instructions. As a last feature, we provide technical info of our units that can be required during troubleshooting. We give the wiring diagram, piping diagram, a component overview, and other required information. Here you can see an example of a piping diagram. You can zoom in if required. If you require any other information, there is a direct link to the business portal. Remember the beginning of this video? You can start an eDoctor session from scanning a new QR code or by continuing a previous session. If you select quit, eDoctor will close, but first you can save the page of your troubleshooting. This way, when you are back on site, you can start up your session where you left off. This is the end of our eDoctor introduction. We hope eDoctor will help you in your future troubleshooting of our Daikin units. We will keep you informed about new developments of eDoctor. In case you have any questions or comments about eDoctor, eCare, or Stand By Me, your local branch will be happy to help.